Hi, I'm John Aspirian, and in this video we're going to take a look at the PerfectIt add-in for Microsoft Word. Professional editors around the world use this software to check the consistency of the text in their documents. I normally review software that works on Macs only. PerfectIt does work on Macs through its cloud application, but as version 4 of PerfectIt for Windows has just been released, I thought I'd take a look at the Windows only version. So I'm looking at the Intelligent Editing website. They're the makers of PerfectIt, and here you can download a free trial or buy the software. As I said earlier, this is an add-in for Word. So you already need Word installed, and this kind of plugs in and enhances its capabilities. It does a lot more than the built-in spell check does. So I've got a Word document here that I'm going to launch, and we're going to use that to demonstrate what PerfectIt actually can do. When you install the add-in, you'll see a PerfectIt for item appear in the menu strip at the top. So if I click on that, and then click on Launch PerfectIt, I'll see a new column on the left-hand side of the screen where I can start using the software to test my document. There are a couple of options here. One of them is about a consistency check. So if you've got a pre-existing style that you want to match the text against, you can select one of the options from this menu here, and beneath that there's a choose checks button, and this will let you drill down and select the specific checks that you want PerfectIt to do. So you can probably get an idea from that of how many different checks it does that go over and above what you get from the normal spell check. I'm not going to make any changes there, but I am going to start the test. So I'm going to click start, and PerfectIt will go off and start to analyze the document. Okay, PerfectIt is now doing its thing to analyze the document. Version 4, the newest version, is much quicker than previous versions, and I've analyzed several thousand words in this document in a matter of seconds. I haven't sped anything up there. So what happens once it starts finding issues that it wants to alert you to, it does everything through this left-hand panel. So here's an example. Hyphenation of phrases is the first test that it's gone through. And in this document, it's found the phrase high hyphen speed 3 times, and it's found high speed without a hyphen once. So you need to make a consistency decision here. Do you want it with a hyphen or don't you? Now, the excellent thing about PerfectIt is that it takes you directly to the examples that it's found. So in this case, high hyphen speed's found 3 times. The other time that it's found where it isn't hyphenated, if I click on this, it's taking me directly to the example. Now, if I want to standardize, I can just click on fix, a hyphen appears in that place, and then I can move on to the next test. Now, there are lots of hyphenation issues in a lot of technical documents that I work with. So tests like this mean that I don't really have to think too much. PerfectIt will go and find all of the consistencies, tell me about them, and then I can make a judgment if there isn't a pre-existing style, where I can choose a prevailing style. If there's lots of one kind and only a few of the other, probably go with lots of the first style. So here's another example. This time I've got high frame rate, found twice, high hyphen frame hyphen rate, found twice. There's no particular preference there, so I just need to look at the document and decide what I think is right. And again, because of the way it's structured, I can just click individual examples, and this will just jump me around the document to show me those in context. And instead of having to fix everything in one go, I can click individual fix buttons and just have certain changes made. I don't have to choose to do them all. The tests continue like this. So this is the hyphenation set of phrases that I'm going through, but there are lots of other tests to come. In this example, I've got a difference of spelling. So whereas I normally would write color with a U, PerfectIt has found one instance where we've got color without the U, the American style of spelling. So again, I want to standardize that, so I can find the example, which is highlighted in the document, click fix, and again, I'm immediately on my way and onto the next set of tests. Here's another example. This time it's abbreviations in two different forms. I've got one term that's written with a single capital letter and the rest in lowercase, but the other examples are in all caps. Again, this isn't very consistent. I need to find which is the best approach. In this test, we've got 79 of one and 3 of the other. Should be pretty clear which ones we want to fix. So I'm going to go in and fix those now. And again, I'll continue on to the next test. Here's another really common test, especially for technical documents, where PerfectIt has searched the document and found a load of terms that it thinks are abbreviations, but they haven't been defined. Now, sometimes it will find things that aren't really abbreviations. For example, I've got HI here, which is simply an example of capitalization rather than something that really is an abbreviation that needs to be spelled out. But there are other cases where, for example, here, might actually want to define what MAC Mac means in this context. So if I wanted to fix that, unlike the previous examples where clicking fix would apply a very clear change, this time I need to tell PerfectIt what I want to change it to. So clicking fix will give me a pop-up window and I can say, well, in this case, Mac means, and I shall type in the definition. And if I do that and click OK, that new text appears in the body content and then puts the abbreviation in brackets afterwards. Let's move on to the next text. And here's another example that pops up all the time, the capitalization of headings. And in this case, I've got one heading where both words start with capitals, whereas in my other headings, I've got only the first word in caps. So if I want to fix protective cover and put the word cover in lowercase, click fix, and that will make that change. Tests like this are really, really helpful in discovering the boring stuff, the stuff that editors need to get right but don't really care deeply about. And they make the editor look brilliant because you will find every instance because it's a computerized check of the content. That leaves you free, leaves your mind free to focus on the juicier kind of meaning of the text that you're editing. So things like this are real time savers and life savers. Let's click next to continue. Okay, we're pretty much at the end now, and I've skipped a few tests to save a little bit of time, but I hope you could get a good idea of the sort of tests that we're going through. As we get towards the end, the finalization tasks, it offers you a load of standard tasks that you can do to update your document. So for example, if you've made substantive changes and you now want to update your table of contents at the start of the document, you can do that. One click, it'll go off and do it and then confirm that it's done it. And there are several other such tasks that you can do, such as accepting track changes and clearing the document properties and getting rid of multiple spaces after paragraphs. And each one that you do, it'll give you a tick to show that it's been done. And then at the end, you can, if you wish, you can have a table of abbreviations created from the document. So if I run that task, it'll pop up and give me examples of all of the abbreviations that have been found through the document. I can see a summary of the changes, so let's run that one. And it'll give me a full report of kind of everything that it's found, which is really, really useful. I can save that out as a separate document. That in itself, if you were to do that and provide it to someone else, makes it look like you've spent hours analyzing the document. It might actually have just been a few minutes. So it's a real time saver and makes you look pretty good. So that is my quick look at PerfectIt. It's a real time saver. It makes you look good. If you're compiling anything like a style guide, this will help you make the right decisions based on, you know, the prevalence of content within the text. So you don't have to make too many qualitative decisions. I've been using PerfectIt for years now, and in fact, as I'm not a Windows fan, it's one of the few reasons keeping me at all tied to having a Windows installation. It is that good that it's worth having, and it's saved me countless hours over the years. So for its price, it's a bargain. Do take a look. As I said, it's a free trial. Fantastic bit of software. And if you've got any questions, leave me a comment. I'll do my best to answer. And thanks for watching.